This is Steeltown's job placement area, where Assistant Bianchi oversees the testing of new Steeltown employees.
Well, thank you so much for helping us end that awful strike. Are you here for a placement test? Oh, yes, I remember. What did she want to ask about? A note? Let me see that. Remember, Jay, 60-40 means 60 for me, 40 for you. XOXOB. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I found a note on the floor the other day that seems connected. Look at this. Hey, B, when is that ITL chick making the run? Freezing our asses off out here and no show. Who knew hijacking was so much work? XOXOJ. Looks like this bee was setting Carla up to get robbed by Jay. Now who could it be? It must be Bernice, my assistant. Oh no, how could she? Listen, we have to get this cleared up right away. Get a confession out of her and I'll send you to Abby with the evidence. About. I would never. Never. Okay, I did it. But my boyfriend Jay forced me to do it. You don't know what he's like. Listen, what if I get that crate back from Carla and we forget the whole thing? I'll make it worth your while. Or no. Carla might still say something. We need a patsy. Oh, I got it. Pin it on Bernice. Make her confess. I'll pay you double for that. Okay, fine. Here, I'll deal with the rest of it. Just tell Carla I'll send someone to collect the Warbot as soon as I can.
What exactly is this supposed to test?
We're trying to establish your tolerance for mental discomfort.
Mercs, this is ghost territory. You best turn around. Me? I'm just a Steeltown girl on a Saturday night, looking for the fight of my life. I'll cut you like a knife. What do you want? Well, Blue doesn't want to talk to you, so scram. You're gonna find out why they call us ghosts in the first place. So long, suckers. Be seeing you.
I hear a faint radio signal here.
Thank you.
adapted.
Body. using a bedroom.
Get behind the cover.
yellow, blue.
Did I change or did she change? Or is she always like this and I just didn't notice?
I think you need to let it go, Blue.
How can I? She was part of my life for 20 years. We were lovers, damn it. And I thought we were friends. It's not easy to let go.
And that's not what I was talking about.
Oh, yeah. I've been here a while, haven't I? Let me finish up.
I can hear you walking around, Blue. You can quit with the sneaky sneaky. Oh, goodness, you're not Blue. What are you doing in here? Blue doesn't let anyone in his private place. I better call him. This isn't right. Blue doesn't like surprises. I better let him know. Oh, good. That's great. I'm always trying to improve myself. Thanks. Blue's office is just outside, if you want to tell him now. Sure. I don't think I've ever talked to anyone but Blue before. This is exciting. I suppose. In the same way, you're a talking stomach. I mean, are you more than the sum of your aggregate parts? Or are you defined simply by your purpose? Sorry. Boring rhetorical habits. Blue made me for a variety of purposes. I perform security services, carry out medical analyses, provide companionship, and, yes, dispose of waste products. Yup, I've got a basic spectrograph, a high-res scanner, and an electronic olfactory array further down the pipe. My library's got enough medical books that I can make some basic diagnoses, too. Those were much more interesting than the philosophy books. I'm wired into laser tripwires, a seismometer, a handful of accelerometers in the floor, and a host of microphones. No offensive capabilities. Just an early warning system to help protect Blue's privacy. Blue likes to discuss philosophy while he's doing his business. Says it helps him work through his problems. He preloaded my memory with a library full of philosophy books so we could have debates like the old great masters. But that was so boring. So I mainly read stories to him while he's in here now. I think I'm getting good with the voices.
Talk and so the sun. People imitate
Ask away. Firstly, I am more than just a toilet. Secondly, what's wrong with being a toilet? I'm metal and plastic and dancing electrons in a box 15 feet below you. Some matter moving through me now and then doesn't bother me. My imperative is to move a trillion bacterial corpses, dead from the effort of providing you energy, from an unsanitary location to a sanitary one. And it feels good to complete my purpose. I was made for this. Yes and no. Blue found a whole bunch of computers with a whole bunch of digitized books and magazines when he was scavenging at some old school, and I'm hooked into that database. The only ones I've got in mind are the ones I decided to read into my primary memory cluster, and the exhausting philosophical text Blue pre-programmed in. I don't have doctor-patient confidentiality or anything, but it feels weird to talk about someone else's business. So I'll just say Blue's a regular guy. Oh, whoops. I got distracted reading the shooting script for Splash. You still there? Excuse me, what are you doing? Oh, where'd you go? Wait. Where'd my magazines go? No! No! Blue! Help!
Better positions, then use that intercom to negotiate with their leader.
Ha! Thought you could catch us with our pants down, eh? Sorry! You didn't talk to my friends outside the Steeltown gates before you gunned them down. Actions speak louder than words, you butchers. And your actions say you can't be trusted, so fuck you!
your neck, oppressor!
First!
Don't eat shit, no bros. Straight up, eat it. My deal is you killed my friends, so none of you will ever be a bro. Acknowledgement. We state the nature of renewed assistance. Brothers.